three-game series between Sam Houston State and Dallas Baptist. Hello again, everybody. My name is Matt Peterson. Delighted to be here. A matchup between two perennial postseason clubs here in Texas. DBU beat Sam Houston last night by a score of 9-7, a wild back-and-forth affair. Sam Houston State fell behind 6-0, but the Bearcats rallied with 3 in the 7th, 2 in the 9th to force extra innings. DBU scored 3 times in the 10th. Bearcats got 1 run back, and DBU took the opener 9-7. Here's a look at our starting pitchers for today. For the Bearcats, it's Riley Gossett, a good start to his season, 2-0 with the 2.45 earned run average. He'll be opposed by the left-hander Cody Funderburk. And Funderburk, an ERA of 4.42 so far this season. Here's the starting lineup for the Dallas Baptist Patriots under head coach Dan Hefner. Hannah, Granberg, and Deuce here in the first inning. Millard, Sandman, and Funderburg, as you can see, a very good hitting pitcher. He oftentimes plays first base when he's not pitching. And then Glowenkey, Bandy, and Jones, the bottom three for the Patriots. And here is the defensive alignment for head coach Matt Deggs and the Bearcats. Freshman Jack Rogers is in left field, along with Hearn and Biles, Cryer, Frigé, Ochoa, and Hefner across the diamond, and Jordan Cannon, the everyday catcher, the battery mate of Riley Gossett. Here we go, set for game two. Bearcats in their orange tops, DBU in the blue tops. And a fastball misses inside. We are underway, 1:04 p.m. here in Huntsville. Another fastball misses high. 74 degrees in Huntsville, Texas. Mostly cloudy. We've had a little bit of a drizzle a few hours ago, but the forecast looks pretty good for this Saturday afternoon. Fastball runs inside, and Artie Life for the DBU dugout. 3 balls, no strikes on Jameson Hanna. Hanna having a great season, hitting 402 on the year. And a fastball's in there for a strike. Brian Clark is the home plate umpire. Michael Grishman's at first, and Brian here is over at third. This is hammered right down the first baseline. Nice pick by Ben Hefner, and he flips to Gossett covering. One away. Perfect defensive alignment from the Bearcats as Hefner was shaded right on top of the first baseline. There's Devlin Granberg. Like Hannah, off to a great start this year, hitting 372 for the year. 5 homers, 28 runs batted in. He steps in. And the first pitch is hit out to center field. Back pedaling a bit as Hearn settles underneath it and he makes a one-handed catch. Granberg retired on the first pitch. Here's Matt Deuce, the catcher. Slow start for Deuce, but he's a very good defensive catcher. Hitting 187, but still batting in the three hole. Shows the faith that head coach Dan Hefner has in him. Fastball hits the outside for a strike. Deuce last night was 1 for 5, and he hit his third homer of the season. That pitch is low, 1 ball, 1 strike. A 3-pitch mix for Riley Gossett, a fastball, a curveball, and a changeup. Typically pounds the zone. He winds and throws, and it's hammered high and foul. And off the light fixture and back into fair territory. I've never seen that happen at Don Sanders Stadium. Now it's picked up by Josh Biles in right field, and Riley Gossett is set to go. Something you might see in Happy Gilmore. A fortuitous bounce for Happy as the pitch misses inside. Here comes Gossett, working quickly. And it's in on the hands, fisted towards second. A few hops for Ochoa. And it's dropped at first base by Ben Hafner. A mistake there for the first baseman. Would have been a 1-2-3 inning. And now the inning continues for the Patriots. Bearcats have played very good defense this year. Two errors last night and three unearned runs in the 10th inning cost them a chance to win. Uncharacteristic of Hafner. Speaking with Taylor Bean before the game, the former shortstop of the Bearcats, about this year's ball club and the infield, which he works with as that curveball drops in. He said the infield has four shortstops. Hafner was a all-conference shortstop at Buffalo before transferring here for his senior season. Ochoa has played shortstop this season for the Bearcats. He's at second base as the 0-1 pitch finds the inside. Back-to-back curveballs to Millard. Frazier, of course, is the shortstop today and most of the season. And Chase Cryer has played shortstop before as well. So it's a very good defensive infield. Millard hitting .329 for the year. Five homers, 19 batted in. The fastball runs low. Millard 1-for-4 last night, and he scored a run. Just underway, top of the first inning in Huntsville. Off speed, good block behind home plate. I'm Jordan Cannon. I asked Coach Matt Deggs about Jordan Cannon behind the plate this year defensively. He said he's been outstanding. I think one of the surprises on this Bearcat team, Jordan Cannon, how good he's been defensively as a catcher. He played the position in high school, but predominantly a pitcher early in his Sam Houston State career. Changeup drops low. A good take that time from Tim Millard. And the count is full. And versatile at the plate. Jordan Cannon batting second for the Bearcats tonight. Oftentimes batting down in the order. Now a table setter here this afternoon. 3-2 pitch, strike three over the outside. Millard caught looking, and Gossett pitches past the air. Nice work from Gossett in the first inning. We stayed here for the mid-inning break as we look at the starting lineup for Matt Deggs and the Sam Houston State Bearcats, 16-6 on the year. Sort out the graphic, but I'll tell you what the starting lineup is. It's Hunter Hearn, Jordan Cannon, and Andrew Frigier, the top of the order for Matt Deggs. And Blake Chisholm, Chase Cryer, and Jack Rogers, the freshman getting the start in left field. Josh Biles in right field batting seventh. Ben Hafner, the first baseman, batting eighth. And Trey Ochoa, the second baseman, batting ninth. The starting pitcher for DBU is Cody Funderburk, a lefty that really pounds the strike zone. Has very good movement on his fastball. And head coach Dan Hafner of DBU just raved about his baseball IQ. Oh, a tough assignment for the Bearcats today. Funderburk on the year, a 4.42 ERA, is 1-2. This afternoon is his fifth start, his sixth appearance overall. And he's allowed 18 hits and 18 in the third innings. Good strikeout number, 17 Ks on the year to go against six walks.
Leading off the bottom of the first for the Bears.
Here's Hunter Herr, has really come into his own this season after really blossoming late last year. A junior hitting 341 on the year. Taps it foul at home plate. Hunter Herr 1-for-5 last night, hit his 5th homer of the year. Herr was batting 5th yesterday, he leads off this afternoon, quickly 0-2. Herr, a team leading 22 runs batted in, 6 doubles, he's slugging 612 on the year. And a fastball misses in. That's the MO for Cody Funderburk. He pounds the strike zone and has some good cut on that fastball. Comes in on the hands of the right-handed batters. And that misses inside. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Fastball sits between 88 and 92. Also throws a curveball and a changeup. Misses inside. From 0-2, the count is full. Throws the cutter against right-handers like Hunter Herr. Swing and a miss. Looked like the cut fastball. And Herr down on strikes. Here's Jordan Cannon. Cannon batted 7th last night, was 2-for-2, a 2-run score. Now in the 2-hole, he takes a fastball high. Cannon 294 on the season, 3 homers, 3 doubles, 9 driven in. Hammers this one foul. Nice play from Matt Deggs. And then he finds a fan in the stands and lobs it to him about 7 rows deep. Matt Deggs was ready. A bare hand play moving to his right. That was nicely done. But he jogged over to the railing and lobbed it into the 8th row. That one is thrown to the backstop by Funderburk. 2-1 the count on Jordan Cannon. Now Matt Deggs, he's been in the third base coach's box some games. He's been in the dugout others. Bounce foul. Reese Johnson picks up the foul ball. It's fun to watch which Bearcat is on foul ball duty. 2-2 the count. And a fastball stays high. There's life in both dugouts. This is a big time series between 2 of the best mid-majors in the region. Swung on and missed the cutter. And he strikes out Cannon on a very similar pitch in which he struck out Herr. Here's Andrew Frigé. 315 on the season. 3 homers, 20 runs batted in. Now Frigé last night 1-for-5 with a homer. Fastball misses outside. It's one of the other things that Taylor Bean and Lance Miles told me when I spoke to them before the game today. As Frigé goes right back up the middle, a base hit. Past the dive of the shortstop, Jimmy Glowenke. A 2-out base runner for the Bearcats after the Frigé single. Here's Blake Chisholm. Bean and Miles told me they were stars on the team last year. And they told me that this team just has a lot more power than their group, which reached the Super Regional in Tallahassee. Power up and down the lineup. That's on display here with Blake Chisholm standing in. Fastball runs low. We'll see how Funderburk attacks Chisholm, the first lefty he's faced. three left-handed batters and one switch hitter in the lineup for Matt Deggs this afternoon. As Matt Deuce goes out and has a quick word with Cody Funderburk. Frazier single right back up the middle. Coach Dan Heefner told me the pitchers love pitching to Matt Deuce as this is hit high and deep to left field, carrying, and that one is gone! A two-run homer for Blake Chisholm. And the Bearcats rallying here with two outs in the first. Chisholm with his fifth homer of the year. Two homers last night. Now three in the series for Blake Chisholm. Now Blake Chisholm going the opposite way on all three homers this weekend. First pitch swinging, Cryer flies it out to right field. Evan Sandman underneath it, and he makes the catch. A good start for the Bearcats. A two-out single from Andrew Frigier, and then Blake Chisholm opposite field, his fifth of the year and third of the weekend. 2-0 Bearcats after one.
Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does bear bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Two runs to work with for Riley Gossett, the sophomore right-hander, after the two-run opposite field homer for Blake Chisholm. Here's another look at the opposite field shot. Beautiful inside-out swing. Chisholm, such a big frame from the left side. Natural power, and that one carried well out of here. 375 to the power alleys, 330 down the line, both in left and right fields. Sandman stands in, and the fastball hits the outside. Gossett looked good in the first inning, struck out Millard looking to end it after a error from Ben Heefner receiving a throw from Ochoa. This is bounced weakly to the right side. Heefner has it. He bobbles it and does not flip to first. Two uncharacteristic errors from Ben Heefner. Very routine plays. And you have to credit Gossett. He was over there so fast. Pitchers have to cover first base, and sometimes they take longer than others. That was lightning quick from Gossett over to first, so he gave Heefner an easy target, and Heefner unable to watch it into his glove. Second error on the first baseman here in the first two innings. First pitch to Funderburk, misses inside. Cody Funderburk hitting .254 on the year. Five homers, 13 runs batted in. He's also today's starting pitcher for DBU. Fastball runs high. Ben Heefner now with four errors on the season. He made two errors in his first 21 games and two today. This is hit up the middle, just past the umpire into center field, a base hit. Stopping at second is Sandman. They have clipped the umpire on its way out there. Oh. Ryan here having to jump out of the way. An error and a base hit, and the table is set for DBU. The pitcher for DBU helping his own cause. Funderburg at first base after the base hit. Here's Jimmy Glowenke, the Patriot shortstop, stands deep in the batter's box. Curveball is popped up on the infield. Frigier backpedaling onto the synthetic surface. Infield fly rule in effect as Frigier puts it away. Glowenke 1-for-5 last night, pops up on the first pitch.
Left fielder, number 42, Luke Bandy.
Now Luke Bandy. Number 8 hitter and left fielder for DBU. 0-for-3 last night. Off to a slow start this year. 3 hits and 19 at-bats. 2 on and 1 out. And it's tapped foul past third. Dan Fitzgerald is the third base coach for DBU, and there's Austin Knight, the first base coach, giving instructions to the back base runner, Funderburg. An error and a single, and then a pop out on the first pitch to Glowenke. 0-1 on Bandy. He lifts it out to right field in the ballpark. Josh Biles with the shades on makes the catch. Biles has a great arm. That throw would have been on line to third. It comes off the glove of Frigier, but he holds Sandman at second. Here's Blaine Jones. Jones, a freshman, batting .213 on the year. Jones came off the bench, was 0-for-2 with the run scored last night, as DBU beat Sam Houston 9-7. First pitch popped up, foul ground. Here comes Cannon, hoping for a play. Jordan Cannon will not make the play. It's off the screen. He was hopeful. Just ran out of room. 0-1 on Jones. Riley Gossett, known as the Goose. Coach Jay Sirianni told me it's hard for the hitters to find him with the ball coming out of his hand. The 0-1. Good curveball, drops over the inside part of the plate. It's 0-2. He's been able to locate that pitch here in the first two innings. No balls and 2 strikes. Here it comes from Gossett. Strike 3, a fastball right down the middle. And for the second straight inning, Gossett pitches past an error and strikes out a DBU hitter looking to end the inning. To the bottom of the second in Huntsville, 2-0 Bearcats.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
At HEB, we are all about Texas beef because we're dedicated to supporting local Texas ranchers, like Dr. Charles Graham from Gonzales, Texas.
I've always loved working ranch animals, so I became a veterinarian to ensure my cattle got the best care 24/7. They need lots of TLC, and I'll make sure to get it.
Ranchers like Dr. Graham are why HEB buys more Texas beef than anyone else. This is the best Texas beef department at HEB. No store does more than my HEB.
We believe the best light beer to have with friends is the original light beer. Always brewed with more taste, less calories, and half the carbs. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Now the home half of the second inning in Huntsville. Matt Peterson with you on a nice March afternoon. Bearcats leading 2-0, a two-out rally. Frigier singled, and then Blake Chisholm, an opposite field homer. Jack Rogers will lead things off. The freshman in the starting lineup today. He came off the bench yesterday. And he's ready to go from the left side. Off speed, hits the outside for strike one. Fifth start of the season for Rogers. Fastball runs inside. Three hits and 21 at bats. One of the hits a home run. Two balls and a strike. Rogers 0 for 4. Last night as DBU beat the Bearcats 9-7. Big swing from Rogers and he fouls it back to the screen. Jack Rogers, an excellent two-way player in high school, yet to pitch for the Bearcats as a freshman this year, but maybe down the road. Today, he's the starting left fielder, trying to get something going for the Bearcats in the second. Full count as a fastball misses. Cody Funderburk out of Queen Creek, Arizona, transfer from Mesa Community College. Swing and a miss. Challenge fastball. Rogers gave it his best cut. Third strikeout for Funderburk. Now it's Josh Biles. Biles also getting an opportunity to start today, his fifth start of the year. Fastball hits the inside corner. Junior batting 294 on the season, one homer, four batted in. And it's hit out to right center, hit pretty well, carrying toward the alley, and that is down for a base hit. Biles takes a big turn and goes back to first. DBU outfield was extremely deep, and that kept it to a single. If they were more shallow, that would have been extra bases for Biles. A one-out single for the Bearcats, and now it's Ben Hafner's turn. Hafner, the senior transfer from Buffalo, hitting 275 for the year. Open stance from the left side. A big hole on the first base side. As Biles runs, it's bounced toward second. Great hands from Jones, flips to second, and on to first, a double play. Spectacular defense. Jones fielded it on the backhand, flipped to Glowenkey, and across to Granberg. And just like that, the Bearcat rally ends. Two innings gone in Huntsville. It's Bearcats 2, Patriots nothing.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom. Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
I know my life is going to be in a better place after I graduate because of the donors who give me their endowment each year.
The Bearcat Champions Fund, building champions.
Welcome back, heading towards the top of the third inning. Two nothing Bearcats. The opposite field home run from Blake Chisholm, still the difference. How about this defense? Blaine Jones, good hands on the backhand, and a nice turn from Glowenke. Hafner retired on the 4-6-3 double play. Blaine Jones, the second baseman, just completed that play. He's a freshman. It's an all-freshman middle infield for DBU. Jones and Glowenke. And Jones, a good two-sport athlete at Munster High School in Texas. He played quarterback in football and threw for over 2,500 yards and 40 touchdowns as a senior. We start the third inning. Hannah leads things off. A top of the DBU order. He bunts it down the third base side. Good bunt picked up there. Throw it across to first. Not in time. Chase Cryer did his best. An excellent bunt and good foot speed for Hannah. Hannah clearly beat it out. DBU specializes in slugging, doubles and homers. They were 13th in the country in home runs last year. But they will take what the defense might give them and they'll use their speed to their advantage, as we saw there with Hannah bunting. This is line past the and down the left field line. Past the glove of Cryer. It's off the wall, picked up by Rogers. And Gossett now in a tough spot. Second and third, nobody out with Matt Deuce coming up. Well, Granberg loves the first pitch. He flew out to center field on the first pitch, his first time up. And he doubles down the left field line on the first pitch from Gossett there. Well, Granberg extends his hit streak to 10 games. From the windup, Gossett comes home. It's lifted out to left center field. This should score a run. Hunter Hearn underneath it makes the catch. His throw will go to third. Scoring from third is Jamison Hanna. And DBU's on the board. It's 2-1 Bearcats. Good throw from Hearn to keep Devlin Granberg at second base. Now it's Tim Millard. 11th RBI of the year for Matt Deuce. Millard struck out looking to end the first inning. Now Gossett goes from the stretch. He just went from the windup to get the fly ball out to center, and his first pitch misses. Devlin Granberg out at second base. I mentioned his 10-game hit streak. He is now 21 for his last 41, hitting over 500 in the last 10 games. Curveball drops low, 2-0. Bearcats 2 in the first on the Blake Chisholm opposite field homer. DBU with the run back here in the third. 2-0 the count. And it's a high pop-up on the infield. Trey Ochoa calls off Hafner and makes the catch. A good pitch from Gossett on 2-0. He induces a pop-up. Now Evan Sandman with two outs. Sandman reached on an error to start the second inning. A fielding error from Hafner, who had a missed catch error in the first. They've worked early in the count in the first three innings against Gossett. And first pitch swinging once again, Sandman fouls it back. 35 pitches so far for Riley Gossett with two outs in the third. A look towards second, and now the pitch, and it's fouled off behind third. Gossett missed all of last year with injury, so they're working him back slowly, getting his pitch count up. He went four innings at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, his last start on St. Patrick's Day. Gave up one unearned run on four hits in those four innings. He struck out five, didn't walk a batter. Fastball is low, one ball, two strikes. 74 pitches his last time out. His season high, 83 pitches against Cincinnati when he worked into the seventh inning. One ball, two strikes. Gossett, the set and the pitch. And it's lofted out to center. Hunter Hearn breaks back, squares his shoulders. And the inning is over. Nice work from Riley Gossett to limit the damage. A single and double to start the inning, but DBU only gets one run. To the bottom of the third in Huntsville, Bearcats leading 2-1.
This is the original light beer. Brewed to be everything you want in a beer and less. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Dude, what's up with your sandwich?
Oh, this is H-E-B Bear Bread. You know, the network, they heard bear and assumed that it meant naked.
So what does bear bread mean?
It just means it doesn't have crust, which makes it great for all kinds of sandwiches, like the BLT or turkey, tuna salad, any of them.
They all do look good.
Yeah, it's totally SFWL. Safe for work lunches.
Makes sense. I get it.
H-E-B Bear Bread, part of H-E-B's Primo Picks All-Star lineup.
You got a little something.
This is the original light beer. And 40 years later, we still brew it the same way. Because when you get something right, you don't mess with it. Miller Lite. Hold true.
Heading towards the bottom of the third inning, Matt Peterson with you, Don Sanders Stadium in Huntsville, as we get a look at each dugout. Bearcats lead the all-time series 26-16 over DBU after the Patriots won the opening game last night, 9-7. Trey Ochoa leads off the third inning for Sam Houston, 9-1-2 in the order. Funderburk comes home and Ochoa, squared to bunt, watches the ball. Funderburk escaped the second inning with the double play ball. It's 2-0. Ochoa's having a great first season with the Bearcats. The junior batting 342. And it's 3-0. High again from Funderburk. Six doubles and a triple for Ochoa. He scored 11 runs. 3-1 the count. Ochoa hit second last night, was 2-for-5 with a run score. Funderburk's come back from 3-0 to work it full. Top of the order, Hunter Hearn on deck. Bounce right back through the box to his left, fielding it, Glow and Key. And Ochoa beats it out. Good hustle from Ochoa. A high chopper over the mound. Glow and Key did his best, but the Bearcats had the leadoff man aboard. Really the first time today they've had the leadoff man on. Somewhat surprising, they've had traffic in each of the first two innings. Four hits already for Sam Houston. Here's Hunter Hearn. Hearn, first pitch swinging, drives it out to right center. Hit pretty well, but Hannah has a beat on it, and he makes the catch just shy of the warning track. Hearn is 0 for 2. He struck out on a cut fastball his first time up. I would think Matt Deggs and the coaching staff would be pleased with that approach from Hearn going to the opposite field. A good swing of the Bearcat center fielder. Now Jordan Cannon in from the right side. Tries to bunt, they throw back to first. Ochoa slides in safely. Cannon struck out on a cut fastball like Hearn in the first inning. as we see Ochoa hustling back to the bag. Cannon ready. It bounces in front of home plate. Funderburk was a junior college first team All-American last year at Mesa Community College in Arizona. As Cannon lifts it out to right field, Evan Sandman in the alley makes the catch. The wind may have taken that one a bit further as we see the flags moving pretty well towards center field. Cannon's 0 for 2. And now Andrew Frigé. A big hit in the first inning. Frigé, a single up the middle. And Blake Chisholm followed with the opposite field homer. Chopped foul off the front foot of Frigé. He's in some pain as he walks around behind home plate. Right off the front toe. He has the top of the foot and ankle protected. That missed the protection there. Funderburk, a very good two-way player last year at Mesa Community College, and continuing that this year for DBU. Frigé swings and misses. It's 0-2. Change up is outside, 1-2. Blake Chisholm on deck. Funderburk works pretty quickly, even with the runner on. The runner goes, and the inning is over. Frigé swings through a pitch out of the strike zone, perhaps a hit and run, or maybe Ochoa was just trying to steal second. Three innings complete in Huntsville. Middle game of the three-game series. Bearcats lead the Patriots 2-1. Funderburk will start the fourth inning for the Patriots. A two-way player, starting pitcher this afternoon, and he already has a base hit at the plate. They singled in the second. Riley Gossett's looked very good. Pounding the strike zone, there's strike one. Only 39 pitches needed so far for Riley Gossett. And it's 0-2. Changeup drops low, a ball and two strikes. Funderburk, Kloenke, and Bandy do up 6, 7, and 8 in the order for DBU. Okay. dismissed. Brian Clark, the home plate umpire, indicating a miss just a bit inside. Two balls and two strikes. Weak chopper towards second. Ochoa charges, watches to his mitt, and throws to first. Funderburk is one for two. Now Jimmy Glowenke, the shortstop. Popped up to shortstop his first time up. He's 0 for 1. One and zero. Coach Dan Heefner of the Patriots said both of his shortstops have a bright future at the plate. 2-0. Both of his middle infielders, I should say, Glowenke and Jones, both freshmen. Says they have a mature approach to the plate, great defensively already. And it's bounced to second. Ochoa, backhand play, uses the infield as he skips it to first. Nice play from Ochoa. He's had a lot of action today. Two ground ball outs for Gossett. Now it's Luke Bandy. Bandy 0 for 1. He'll talk things over with Dan Heefner before his two out at bat. Good curveball in there for a strike. Bandy, the second baseman for most of last year after Luke Stratman was lost to injury in mid-April. Fastball misses, 1-1. Bandy, the left fielder today for the Patriots. This is hammered into left field. Pitch left up in the zone by Gossett. Bandy aboard with a two-out single. Blaine Jones now for DBU. Munster High School won the Class 2A state title last year. As it's hit towards third, and past the glove of Chase Cryer down the left field line. Long run for Rogers. They're going to wave in the runner. Frigé will not throw off. It's 2-2. Ground ball down the line that Cryer cannot feel cleanly. Both teams finding payday with two outs today. Top of the order now for Jamison Hanna. They will score a double. Hanna ready, a bunt base hit his last time up. Ball one. Third double of the year for Blaine Jones, his fifth run batted in. And I told you that Jones was part of that Munster High School team which won the 2A state title last year. He was the most valuable player of the state tournament. Now standing at second base after his RBI double. Nice pitch, swung on and missed. Looked like a fastball and Hanna was, or a changeup, and Hanna was out in front. Hanna grounded out his first time. He is 1 for 2. Two and one. Bearcats with two in the first on the Blake Chisholm home run. DBU's rallied with single runs in the third and here in the fourth to tie it up. Similar feel to last night. A back and forth game after DBU had a 6-0 lead. Nice block behind home plate by Jordan Cannon. 3-1 the count. A rare three ball count for Riley Gossett, who has not walked a batter. A hitter's count for Hannah. Foul back. Coach Dan Heefner, high praise for Hannah, said he should be a high draft pick this year, maybe as high as the top five rounds. A nice year in the Cape Cod League last summer. Very good runner, as we saw on his bunt base hit his last time at the plate. Gossett trying to end the inning and strand Jones at second base. Strike three over the outside. Good pitch from Gossett, who picks up his third strikeout. DBU ties it up, but they leave one runner at second base. Now to the home half of the fourth. 2-2 at Huntsville.
Mustang Mania. All three of these fans will be walking away with prizes from Delphic Ford. Probably one is going to win a free oil change. Ashley is going to be representing the yellow Mustang. Madeline will be rooting for the gray Mustang. And if the red Mustang crosses first, then Marcy is going to be our grand prize winner. All right, let's turn our attention to the video board and see what happens.
Now the bottom of the fourth inning in Huntsville, 2-2 to score. Lefty on lefty. First pitch is bounced through, and they sit into left. Chisholm loving the opposite field this weekend. Three homers to left field, and there's a first pitch base hit. Pass shortstop. Chisholm is 2-for-2. That was his swing in the first inning, opposite field home run after the Frisier single. Blake Chisholm 2-for-2 today. Now it's Cryer. He swings at the first pitch and comes up empty against a curve. Cryer flew out to right field to end the first inning. Bearcats 2 in the first, DBU with single runs in the third and fourth to tie it up. Good. 0-2 on Chase Cryer. Cryer entered today's game with the best batting average on the Bearcats, 364 for the year. Plus 7 doubles and 2 homers. Chased a bad one there, out of the zone. Fifth strikeout for Cody Thunderbird. Now Jack Rogers. Good at bat, a good battle in the second, but he struck out swinging. Big cut from Rogers, 0-1. This is a strikeout pitching staff entering this weekend. The Patriots had compiled 191 strikeouts in their first 19 games, an average of almost 10 and a half per game. 1-1, a change up in the dirt. Funderburk has already matched a season high with his 5 strikeouts. Hit run from the Bearcats, it's a foul ball. Devlin Granberg tried to keep it fair, leaping towards home plate as he snared the baseball. Funderburk also had 5 strikeouts against Oklahoma at the end of February. And at Oklahoma State, a short start his last time out against Baylor. Lasted only 2 innings, gave up 3 runs. 1-2 pitch and it hit him on the right shoulder. A mistake that time from Funderburk. Maybe further up the back, right across the numbers of Rogers. He'll take it, he takes first base and Chisholm up to second. Now it's Josh Biles, a single to right field his first time up. Fastball outside. That is only the second hit batter of the season for Funderburk in over 22 innings. 1 ball and no strikes. Cutter misses in, 2-0, a hitter's count now for Biles. Ben Hafner on deck. Bearcats looking to regain the lead. A high strike is called. Outfield is deep. Left fielder Bandy shaded towards the left center field alley. A second baseman Jones shaded towards second base. Fly ball out to right center. Hannah coming over. And the two outfielders collide, but Hannah makes the catch as Sandman converged from right field. Now it's Ben Hafner. Hafner made good contact, but bounced into a 4-6-3 double play to end the second inning. Two runs, 5 hits, no errors for DBU. 2 runs, 5 hits, 2 errors for Sam Houston. Good pitch over the inside. 0-1. And it's fisted over third and down for a base hit. Chisholm will be waved in. He'll score. Stopping at second is Rogers. A 2-out hit for Hafner. And the Bearcats retake the lead 3-2. Good piece of hitting from Hafner. He had a walk-off hit that looked like that a few weekends back against Cincinnati. And the ninth inning or extra innings going down the left field line. A similar approach from the senior. And a nice bounce back after he committed 2 errors in the first 2 innings at first base. Now Trey Ochoa with 2 outs. Ochoa stays hot, a infield single his first time. First pitch swinging, popped up foul. Out of play on the first base side. sixth RBI of the season for Ben Hafner. 3-2 Bearcats. One and one. No activity yet in the DBU bullpen. A left-hander is up and working in the Bearcat bullpen. Swing and a miss. Good off-speed pitch. I'm Cody Funderburk. Good take from Ochoa, just a bit outside, 2-2. Top of the order, Hunter Hearn on deck for the Bearcats. 59 pitches so far for Funderburk. His season high, 85. Two starts ago at Oklahoma State. Ochoa deep in the batter's box. And another good eye. Takes the curveball in the dirt. Now a full count. And with two outs, both base runners will be off. Rogers from second and Hafner from first. Outfield remains very deep with the wind blowing out towards right center. Just a bit inside. Excellent eye from Ochoa. It was 1-2 and he works a walk, the first issued by Cody Funderburk today. Rogers up to third, Hafner moves up to second. And now, the benefit of batting Hearn first, you have power at the top of the order. Hearn is fifth homer of the season last night. A chance to break it open a little bit for the Bearcats. And a visit to the mound from Deuce. He'll talk things over with Funderburk, and activity will start in the DBU bullpen. Hearn is 0-2. Struck out on a cut fastball in the first inning, flew out to center field on the first pitch in the third inning. A mound visit now from the pitching coach, Rick McCarty, third season with the Patriots. Mm-hmm. 61 pitches so far for Funderburk, who's yielded three runs on six hits in 3 2/3. You can see the right-hander getting loose in the DBU bullpen.
Cody, you're doing it, Cody.
Cragen Keckley getting loose, a sophomore right-hander. Here's Hearn. Hearn slugging 612 on the year, best for the Bearcats. First pitch is outside and nearly to the backstop as Deuce kept it nearby. Rogers was hit by a pitch. He's at third. Hafner, an RBI single, is at second. Ochoa, a great at bat and a well-earned walk. He's at first. Outfield is deep. A 1-0. Fastball over the inner half. One ball, one strike on Hearn. Jordan Cannon on deck. 3-2 Bearcats in the home half of the fourth. A long look in from Funderburk as he reads the signs from Matt Deuce. High chopper towards short, difficult play. Glowing key, long throw to first, and it's picked out by Granberg. Nicely done by the DBU first baseman. A 6-3 putout ends the inning. The Bearcats leave them loaded, but they get the lead on an RBI single from Ben Hafner. After four in Huntsville, it's Sam Houston 3, Dallas Baptist 2. Riley Gossett pitching with the lead for the second time today. His team handing him a 3-2 advantage as he takes the mound for the fifth inning. 56 pitches so far for Riley Gossett. Now Cross Austin comes in to play first base. And Ben Hafner moves from first to third. Chase Cryer is now out of this game. So the infield for the Bearcats, Hafner at third, Frigier the shortstop, Ochoa the second baseman, Cross Austin's the new first baseman. Granberg stands in and a fastball is low. Devlin Granberg, a nice pick at first base to end a Bearcat four. That was the bases loaded on Hearn's ground ball to short. Well, those plays that doesn't really show up in the box score, but a pivotal play for DBU to end the inning. 2-0 on Granberg. He doubled down the left field line to extend his hit streak to 10 games. And a line drive base hit up the middle. Granberg is so hot. Bearcats have the defense positioned correctly with Ochoa basically standing behind second, but that was hit so hard he couldn't make a play. Granberg 2-for-3 today after two hits and two RBIs last night. Matt Deuce now from the left side. Granberg a big lead at first. It's 1-0. Granberg, an excellent base dealer, 8-for-8 on the season. And it's lifted out to left. Racing over is Rogers at the wall. He'll make the catch. Nice play from the freshman. Limited playing time in left field this year. He looked very comfortable on that play, ranging back onto the warning track and making the over the shoulder catch. That's a big first out for Riley Gossett. Now it's Tim Millard. Cut, he fouled it back to the screen. Millard is 0-for-2, struck out looking his first time, popped up his last. A team best 657 slugging percentage. Millard 8 doubles and 5 homers on the year. Fouled off towards the DBU bullpen. Coach Dan Hefner said Millard's one of the key guys in the lineup, a very mature approach. Very complete hitter. Gossett ahead in the count 0-2. One ball and two strikes. Gossett's dealt with base runners all afternoon. DBU so far today, 3-for-11 with runners on base. And down to second goes Granberg. Good read from the first baseman who read a ball in the dirt and took second base. See how they score. It could be a steal or a wild pitch. I would score that a stolen base myself. Possible tying run now in scoring position. And he hit him on the left arm. Millard will take first base. Right on the left bicep. Jay Sirianni out to the mound has made the call to the bullpen. That is the end of the line for Riley Gossett. Gossett works 4+ innings.
Across division. Championships and schools. For nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
What does it mean to be Southland Strong?
It's not just big wins.
It's success in the classroom.
And being engaged with service.
Family.
Passion.
Integrity.
Overcoming adversity.
Hard work and dedication.
Bettering people around you.
Striving for excellence.
Leadership and competition.
On our campuses.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Seth Ballou is the new pitcher for the Bearcats. Ballou is having a great season. A junior is 0-1 with a 2.82 earn run average. Versatile, a Swiss Army knife for Coach Matt Deggs. He started the first three games of the year, but has worked out of the bullpen the last four. His last time out was Tuesday night at Texas. A scoreless inning with a walk and two strikeouts. Three straight scoreless appearances for Seth Ballou. Before Texas, he was at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, and before that at Baylor. Well, Ballou coming out of the bullpen has already thrown 22 and a third innings this year. Oh, he may be stretched out a bit as he enters this game with one out in the fifth. Gossett's last batter was Millard. He hit him, and that's set the table for Sandman. 2 on, 1 out. Bearcats leading 3-2 in the fifth. Sandman is 0-for-2. Reached on an error and a fly ball to center field. First pitch misses, ball one. Big swing and a miss from Sandman. Last year, Ballou, 18 appearances after having Tommy John surgery in 2016. had a year and a half of rehab. Misses outside. A three-pitch mix for Seth Ballou. Fastball, a curveball, and a changeup. Granberg's at second, Allard at first. 3-2 Bearcats in the fifth. Fastball stays high. Fastball in the upper 80s. One thing Jay Sirianni told me about Ballou is very good at handling the running game. Two on with one out. Tipped into the glove of Cannon, who hangs on to it. Now the count is full. Bearcat outfield is deep and shaded towards right. Left fielder Jack Rogers well off the line in the alley. Hafner, the third baseman, is towards the shortstop hole. Frazier towards second. And a walk. A single, a hit batter, and a walk, and the bases are loaded. Cody Funderburk, the starting pitcher for DBU. So far today, he's 1-for-2. Singled his first time, grounded out to second his last. And now Matt Deggs will come out of the dugout. I'm sure he and the entire staff disappointed Ballou coming into the game, walking the first man he faced. Offense has done pretty well, scoring 3 runs in the first 4 innings, but a pitching staff has not been that clean today. We mentioned all the traffic that DBU has had on the bases. As Deggs talks things over with Ballou. 11 at-bats already today with runners on base. DBU yet to have really the clutch hit. They're 0-for-6 with runners in scoring position. We'll see how the Bearcats approach this defensively, leading 3-2. Middle infield double play depth. Ben Hafner, the third baseman's about halfway and off the line. First baseman, Cross Austin, plays behind the back runner, Sandman. First pitch swinging line towards second. Nice play, Ochoa to Frazier for one, and a double play. Spectacular defense from Trey Ochoa. And on the first pitch to Funderburk, a double play ends the inning. The pep talk for Matt Deggs worked out. We go to the bottom of the fifth, 3-2 Bearcats.
All right, Ben. Today we have Amy, and she has a chance to win a gift card from HBCU Guest. If the price shown on the board is actually over or under the actual price. Are you ready?
I am.
All right. HBCU Raspberry Chipotle Marinade Sauce. $2.98. Is it over or under?
Good life for that Bearcat dugout after some excellent defense. Trey Ochoa picking up Seth Ballou and Riley Gossett with the double play. Here is how the top half of the inning ended. On the first pitch to Funderburk, grounded to Ochoa, and Frazier with the turn. Ochoa's having a great game. A single and a walk and some outstanding defense at second base. Ochoa has committed one error this year. He started 20 games. His fielding percentage, .986 between shortstop and second base. Now the Bearcats, 20 errors. Make that 22 errors in now 23 games. Two last night, two today. So not their most clean defensive game, but Ochoa right there in a big spot. Bases loaded, one out. Gets the Bearcats out of the jam. Here's Jordan Cannon, the catcher. And the pitch stays high. Funderburk bounced into that inning-ending double play. Back to the mound, and pitch misses. 66 pitches so far for Cody Funderburk, the starter for DBU. Cannon's 0-for-2, a strikeout and a fly ball to right. This is fouled right past the Bearcat dugout. Bearcats entered the weekend, averaging 6 runs per game. Had a 9-game win streak snapped Tuesday night in Austin. And then the loss last night in extra innings. Sharp ground ball to short, off the glove of Glowenkeep. And Cannon is aboard. As we take another look. Came off the heel of the glove. How about that? First error of the season for Jimmy Glowenke. It's his 21st start. Now Frigé squares to bunt, takes a ball. Now Glowenke, a 1,000 fielding percentage. 44 assists. 24 putouts coming into play today. His first error of his freshman season. Frigé swings through a good curveball. It's 1-1. Frigé, a base hit. One batter before Chisholm's two-run homer, his first time up. And then Frigé struck out swinging his last time up. Here he pushes a bunt back towards the mound. Throwing to second for the force out is Funderburk. Nice play from the pitcher. We know he's a very good first baseman and a smart baseball player. He made that look pretty easy. Not a terrible bunt from Frigé. Pushed it towards no man's land near second. Against many pitchers that might get past them and a bunt base hit. Cannon forced at second, Frigé at first after the fielder's choice. Here's Blake Chisholm. Went to the opposite field with the base hit his last time up after a booming home run to left field his first. Pitches outside for a ball. Coach Dan Hefner said, outstanding baseball IQ for Funderburk. He said when he's at first base, he is sort of the captain of the infield, organizing his defense based off the opposing hitter who's up. A strike call to throw to first. Frigé back in standing. Said he knows the game inside and out. One of the changeups, according to Hefner, for Funderburk today is his changeup. Chisholm takes, it's 2 balls and a strike. Hefner thought that changeup could play well against the Bearcats approach. And it's foul right past Matt Deggs, down the left field line. Excellent hustle from Reese Johnson. A A freshman infielder nearly got there before the ball stopped rolling. He'll get a few high fives on his way back to the dugout. Runner goes, and Chisholm does well to stay alive, fouling it off. Frigier off from first base on that 2-2 pitch. Coach Matt Dex told me Blake Chisholm is just locked in at the plate before the game today. And he's followed suit. A homer, a single, two-run score. 3-2 Bearcats in the fifth. And it's lined out to left center. Another opposite field hit. Frigier takes the turn and goes to third. Chisholm up to second with the double. And now Chisholm is a triple shy of the cycle. Textbook approach from the big designated hitter, Blake Chisholm. Three opposite field homers this weekend. Three opposite field hits today. And that will be the end of the line for Cody Funderburk. He gets one out in the fifth, throws a total of 77 pitches. And the new pitcher coming in for Dallas Baptist, Craigan Keckley. We'll take a break. Bearcats threatening, and they lead 3-2 in the fifth.
Growing the growl is not just a saying or an expression. I take it as more of a Bearcat way.
It's time for everybody to get together. So anybody comes out, the community of Huntsville comes out and just get together, wear your orange.
To me, Grow the Growl is more than just letters on a stadium or words on a pamphlet. It's more about an overall feeling of spirit.
You make the commitment to come to Sam Houston. Commit all the way, 100%.
Success does not come easy. Winning championships takes hard work on the field of play and in the classroom by our student athletes.
Thank you for blessing me with this opportunity and your support so that our future Bearcats can continue our winning tradition.
Play your part in building champions and become a Bearcat champion today.
Craigan Keckley, the new pitcher for DBU, his ninth appearance of the season. So far, 9 hits allowed in 13 innings, 13 strikeouts, and only 4 walks issued. He's 1-0 with a 3.46 Ehrman average. Well, he comes on as the fireman here in the fifth. 2 in scoring position for the Bearcats and only 1 out. Frigier reached on a fielder's choice, and then Blake Chisholm, an opposite field double. That was Chisholm's fifth double of the year. Craigan Keckley out of Austin, Texas in Vista Ridge High School. 6 foot, 200 pounds. He last pitched on Sunday against Brown. 3 innings, 1 hit, 1 run. A walk and 2 strikeouts through 46 pitches. So he's been stretched out a little bit. That was his longest outing of the year. And he may be asked to go a few here today if he's on. Cross Austin will bat for the first time today. He came on as a defensive replacement. And he bats for the first time in a big spot. The corner infielders are up. The middle infielders are back. 3-2 Bearcats. That misses outside, ball one. Austin batting in the place of Chase Cryer. Another breaking ball is low, 2-0. Austin did not feature in last night's game, has a hitter's count. And that pitch misses. Three breaking balls all out of the zone. Two hits in 15 at-bats for the year. One of the hits, a triple. An open base and a 3-0 count. Fastball right there. Craig and Keckley facing Cross Austin. Bearcats trying to add to its 3-2 lead. Swing and a miss. Good slider. And the count is full. Jack Rogers on deck for the Bearcats. Swing and a miss. From 3-0 to a strikeout for Craig and Keckley. Now a big spot for Jack Rogers. Rogers struck out his first time, was hit by a pitch and stranded at third base in the fourth. Reagan Keckley has his sign. Another good breaking pitch is in there for strike one. And Matt Deuce, the catcher, will go out and speak with Keckley. Bearcats, number 22 in the D1Baseball.com to start the week. DBU has been in the polls at various times this year. DBU is number 18 in the preseason for D1Baseball.com. One ball, one strike. Josh Biles would be next for the Bearcats. That just missed, 2-1. Big swing and a miss from the freshman. Steps out to collect his thoughts. 2-2. Rogers right on top of the plate from the left side. Keckley stares in and has his sign. That bounces away from the catcher. Deuce racing in to score is Frigie. Well, Frigie was ready, a good secondary lead, and he bounded home. A mistake there. Keckley one strike away from getting out of the inning. And the Bearcats stretch the lead to 4-2. A tough pitch to block for Deuce. It was a short hop as it hit the opposite batter's box before the catcher. A wild pitch scores Frigie. Rogers taps it foul. Chisholm moved from second to third on the wild pitch. 3-2 the count. Two outs, a run in for the Bearcats. A foul ball and Deuce unable to squeeze it. So another pitch to face for Jack Rogers. It's lofted out to left field, but right at the left fielder, Bandy, who makes the catch. Not a bad approach from Rogers on two strikes, but hit right into the defense. The Bearcats add on an unearned run. We go to the sixth inning from Huntsville. It's Sam Houston 4, Dallas Baptist 2. Fans staying hydrated between innings as we move towards the sixth inning. And Nick Mikolacik will come out of the bullpen to start the sixth. Miko will follow Seth Ballou, got the double play off the bat of Cody Funderburk to end the fifth inning. Third pitcher used today by the Bearcats. Riley Gossett went 4 1/3 innings, gave up 2 runs, 6 hits, no walks, and 3 strikeouts, 66 total pitches. Ballou 2/3 of an inning, 1 walk, and now it's Mikolacik. Mikolacik will face the bottom three in the order for DBU. Glowen, Key, Bandy, and Jones due up. Mikolacik, a great freshman year. He appeared in 32 games last year. Fastball runs low. Today's his 12th appearance of 2018. Fastball hits the outside. Mikolacik, his last time out, took the loss at Texas on Tuesday night. Outside 2-1, 6 hits, 2 runs, a walk and 2 strikeouts. He lasted 3 2/3 innings. Now the 2-1 pitch, fouled back. Mikolacik began the season as the closer. Dakota Mills has grabbed that role by the scruff of the neck and run with it. And now Mikolacik entering this game and fielding his position well. He picks up the loose ball, slings it to first in time, where Cross Austin takes it. Good composure there from Mikolacik. Had it fall to his right, lost sight of the baseball for a few seconds, but recovered well. Glowen Key is retired. He's 0-3. Sidearm throw while leading back from Mikolacik. Luke Bandy now. Pitches up in the zone. Bandy singled and scored his last time, a fly out to right, his first trip. Pitches outside. Perhaps Mikolacik's best outing of the year was at Baylor. He picked up the win. 4 innings of relief work as the Bearcats won in Waco. No runs allowed on just 2 hits. Bandy swings and misses to a high fastball. Well, that was probably a nice snapshot for Matt Deggs and Jay Sirianni and the rest of the pitching staff of Mikolajczyk's possibilities as a starting pitcher. This is lined out to center. Hearn racing towards the alley. He makes the catch on the run. Nicely done from Hunter Hearn. It's actually Mac Odom out there. I beg your pardon. Hearn has moved to right field. Odom's in center. Clayton Harp is the new left fielder for the Bearcats. Odom in there for his defense, coming up big, taking away possible extra bases from Bandy. Now it's Blaine Jones. Base is empty, two outs. First pitch swinging, bounces it towards third, backhanded and into foul ground. And it's an infield single. Now Ben Hafner moved from first to third. Another opportunity to make a play, but could not. Not an easy play by any means. And a two-out base runner as Jameson Hanna steps to the plate. Big swing and a miss from Hanna. Hanna with his bunt single in the third extended his career-long hit streak to 22 games. Big swing and a miss. Mikolajczyk has fooled him badly twice. Jameson Hanna, a preseason All-American, third team selection by D1Baseball.com. Batting here with two outs in the sixth. Mikolajczyk trying to end the inning. And it's off the glove of Cross Austin into shallow right field. Racing to third is Jones. And DBU extending the inning with two outs. I think Trey Ochoa would have been able to make the play if it did not hit the glove of Austin. Ochoa was in good position. But Austin trying his best, diving to his right. Jones, his second hit, had an RBI double his last time. Or Hanna, his second hit, I beg your pardon. Jones goes all the way to third base. Devlin Granberg now. Pitch misses, one ball, no strikes. Granberg 2 for 3, a single his last time, a double down the left field line in the third. Four two Bearcats, two outs in the top of the sixth. High fly ball deep to left. Rogers will watch that fly out of here. DBU takes a 5-4 lead on a three-run homer from Devlin Granberg. No doubt about it. You can tell by the reaction from Rogers and left, or Harp and left. And Granberg celebrates with his teammates on his way back to the dugout. Sixth homer of the year for Devlin Granberg. Fastball misses in. Now 31 RBIs on the year. This is roped down the right field line, foul. Oh, Granberg, like Blake Chisholm, a triple shy of the cycle. Powerful swing from Granberg. Hit well out to center. Mac Odom in the alleyway will make the catch, and the inning is over. Bearcat defense a little bit shaky, and then a three-run homer from Devlin Granberg. And DBU has its first lead of the afternoon. To the bottom of the sixth in Huntsville, 5-4 Patriots.
All right, everyone, we're with Johnny and Sam.
Now the Bearcats will have to come from behind. It's 5-4 DBU. The Bearcats show their resolve and grit, rallied from 6 runs down to force extra innings yesterday, only to lose 9-7 in 10. Bearcats have led 2-0 and 4-2, but a 3-run shot from Devlin Granberg has given DBU the lead. Clayton Harp will bat for the first time today. Came in last inning as a defensive replacement. Harp was 0-for-1 last night, and he swings and misses to the first pitch. Harp having a good season, 328 average, a homer, 7 batted in. And he takes strike 2. Keegan Keckley recorded the final 2 outs of the 5th inning. He returns for the 6th, the DBU. Slow roller right side, Jones over to first, and there's 1 out. Ben Hafner now will stand in. An RBI single out to left. Nice opposite field approach his last time in the 4th. Bounced into a double play his first trip. Ball 1. Hafner's had a rough day defensively. Made 2 errors in the first 2 innings at first base. And then a makeable play at third extended the top half of this inning. He couldn't put it away on the backhand. On the ground ball from Jones right over the bag. And then 2 batters later, Devlin Granberg making the Bearcats pay with the 3-run homer. 2-1. And there's a base hit to right. Good swing from Hafner on a pitch in on the hands. Hafner, his 2nd hit today, and now Trey Ochoa. Ochoa has walked and had an infield single and some excellent defense out at 2nd base. Runner goes and it's tap foul. Hafner off with the first pitch. Possible hit and run there from the Bearcats. Ochoa ready from the right side. Good curveball is over the inside for our 0-2. Ochoa has now reached base in 20 straight games. Ochoa listed as a switch hitter, but he's batting right-handed against the righty, Keckley. Throw to first, back in safely is Hafner. Dallas Baptist, 5 runs, 8 hits, and 1 error. Bearcats, 4 runs, 8 hits, and 3 errors. Defense has cost the Bearcats this weekend. 3 unearned runs in the 10th inning last night. Chisholm and Cryer each with errors. Bearcats with 3 errors committed today. Defense has been very good most of the year. Fastball is outside. Coach Deggs likes to say we dominate routine plays. After many wins this year, he said that. Good pitching, dominated routine plays, and had good offense, timely hitting to win. And just great start to the year for the Bearcats. 16-6 entering today's game. And Ochoa strikes out, a good curveball from Keckley. Second strikeout for Keckley. Well, now Hearn a chance to extend the inning. Hearn 0-for-3 today. Hafner back in standing. Hearn struck out his first time, a fly out to center. Pretty good contact in the third, and then a ground out to short. He nearly beat it out. Hearn drives it out to center field, but right at Hannah, and he makes a catch right over his shoe tops. Sinking line drive from Hearn, good contact from the center fielder, but he lines out to end the inning. Six innings complete from Don Sanders Stadium. DBU leads Sam Houston 5-4. Some young Bearcats taken in this game. They are dressed for some baseball. Sitting in the first row here at Don Sanders Stadium. Four, five, and six due up in the seventh inning for DBU against Nick Mikolacik, Tim Millard, Evan Sandman, and Cody Funderburk. Fastball's there for a strike. Mikulacic gave up the three-run homer to Devlin Granberg with two outs last inning. That pitch misses low. Third home run allowed this year by Mikulacic. Two balls and a strike. Bearcats scored twice in the first. DBU single runs in the third and fourth to tie it up. Sam Houston regained the lead with single runs in the fourth and the fifth. This is hammered down the left field line and foul off the screen in front of the Bearcat bullpen. Two balls and two strikes. Count is full. High chopper foul. out to right. And over to make the catch is Odom. Pretty good swing with two strikes from Millard. Driving it out to right field on the outside pitch. Millard 0 for 3 was hit by a pitch in the fifth. Now it's Evan Sandman. Good pitch called a strike. Sandman walked his last time. He's also flown out to center and reached on an error. Fastball outside, it's 2-0. One more game tomorrow between these teams. 1 p.m. first pitch here in Huntsville. Two balls and a strike. The Bearcats have a midweek game at UT Arlington on Tuesday, and then they resume Southland Conference play against Abilene Christian next weekend. 1-2 pitch popped up. Frigé calling off Hafner, and he makes the catch. Sandman retired, 0 for 3. Cody Funderburk, who started this game as the pitcher and is now the DH, singled his first time, grounded out his next trip, and then an inning-ending double play, coaxed by Seth Ballou. First pitch swinging, he swings and misses. Bearcats 6-0 in the Southland Conference, and all six of those games away from home. They swept Lamar and Texas A&M Corpus Christi away from home. This is roped to the right side, fielded there by Cross Austin. He flips to Mikulacic covering, and the inning is over. Nice play from Cross Austin, and good awareness from Mikulacic covering first base. Time to stretch at the Dawn. It's 5-4 Dallas Baptist. The fans enjoying this one, including a few down from Dallas. As we've reached the seventh inning stretch. Keckley stays in the game for DBU. And has gone 1 2/3 innings so far. Bearcats next week. It's a Thursday, Friday, Saturday series against Abilene Christian on Easter weekend. Thursday and Friday, both those games on ESPN3. 6:30 start time on Thursday and Friday.
Leading off the bottom of the seventh for the Bearcats, catcher number 25, Jordan Cannon.
And the Bearcats then go to Rice for a midweek game April 3rd and at Nichols before a four-game homestand, Baylor midweek and Stephen F. Austin through the middle of April. Jordan Cannon will lead things off. Bearcats trailing 5-4. Difference so far in this game, Devlin Granberg's three-run homer in the sixth. First pitch swing and a good cut from Cannon. He fouled it back. Cannon's 0 for 3. Reached on an error his last time. A fly out to right and a strikeout. Five runs, eight hits, one error, and seven left on for the Patriots. Four runs, eight hits, three errors, and six left on the bases for Sam Houston. This Bearcat team can score late in games. We've seen that all year, especially here at the Dawn. After last night's game, Coach Matt Degg said the wind was blown out towards left, and DBU is one of the best hitting teams in the country. And just one of those games, tough to slow down an offense like the Patriots. Swing and a miss. Good pitch from Keckley. Coach Degg said they threw a haymaker right off the bat and connected. But I'm really proud of our guys after the Bearcats reversed a six-run deficit to force extras. Curveballs over the inside corner and a called third strike. Cannon back to the dugout, his second strikeout today. Keckley's been very good, three strikeouts so far. Now Andrew Frigé. Frigé singled and scored in the first, struck out in the third, reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the fifth. First pitch in there for a strike. 32 pitches so far for Keckley. Coach Deggs, after last night's game, said we really proved that we don't have a glass jaw and got back up off the mat and started punching back. Frigé fouls it back behind in the count 0-2. Coach Deggs commended the work out of the bullpen for Dominic Robertson and Riley Cooper. Robinson an inning and a third of scoreless baseball. Riley Cooper went 4 1/3 innings. Here's a pop-up. First base side. Granberg, the first baseman. It'll make the catch. Tough at bat for Frigé. And two quick outs for the Bearcats in the seventh. Now it's Blake Chisholm. He is locked in at the plate. His average up to .333 with three hits today. A two-run opposite field homer in the first. A single to left and a run scored in the fourth. And then a double to the left center field alley in the fifth. Takes a fastball over the inside. Riley Cooper was so good for the Bearcats in the postseason last year, especially in the Lubbock Regional as the Bearcats emerged. Fouled off the front foot of Chisholm. Keckley is just pounding the strike zone. And it's 0-2. Chisholm just stays alive. From my vantage point, it looks like Keckley's throwing some nasty stuff up there as the Bearcats just trying to make good contact against Keckley. Cannon struck out looking, Frigé with the pop out, and now Chisholm behind in the count. Good take there from Chisholm, it's 1-2. Coach Deggs, after last night's loss, said, I'm really proud of the fact that they didn't knock us out. We got up and kept coming and then got into our game. The Bearcats need another comeback today. Fouled off by Chisholm. So Riley Cooper is really effective against great bat speed, and those guys have great bat speed. Speaking of the DBU hitters. One ball and two strikes. Chisholm trying to get something going for the Cats. Strike three over the outside. He takes it and is rung up. Two strikeouts in the inning, four out of the bullpen overall for Keckley. After seven innings in this Saturday afternoon contest, it's 5-4 Dallas Baptist. Nick Mikulacik stays out there for the eighth inning. And a new first baseman for the Bearcats, Jackson Grisham, is manning first base. First pitch swinging. Glowinki bounces it to short. Frigé, a good throw across the diamond. Jimmy Glowinki retired on one pitch. He's 0 for 4 today. Now Luke Bandy. Some tough outs in the bottom of the order today for Dallas Baptist. Bandy is 1 for 3. Fastball outside from Mikulacik. 34 pitches on the afternoon for Mikulacik, who has worked 2 1/3 innings. All three of those runs unearned. Now it seems like they changed that scoring decision from a couple innings ago. It was initially ruled a hit off the bat of Blaine Jones, and now it seems like they scored an error against Ben Hafner. So it's 3 unearned runs for Mikulacik. Says drilled out to right center. Back is Odom, and he makes the catch. Backpedaling towards the wall. Nice play from Odom, a very good defensive outfielder. Now Blaine Jones, and indeed they did score it an error after initially scoring it a base hit. First pitch swinging, pops it up towards third. Hafner under it will make the catch. Nice work from Mikulacik, who retires the side in order. We go to the bottom of the eighth from Don Sanders Stadium. 5, 6, and 7 due up for the Bearcats. It's 5-4 Patriots.
All right, fans, it's now time for today's CHI Pocket Letter Contest. If you have a Ford car key, please show the Barefoot Posse on the home dugout to win a prize from CHI Emergency Center. Once again, a Ford car key.
The fans enjoying Sweet Caroline as we head towards the bottom of the eighth. Matt Peterson with you from Don Sanders Stadium. A tough series between two battle-tested teams. Bearcats and the Patriots in the postseason year in, year out of the last decade plus. And Jackson Grisham will step to the plate. First at bat for Grisham today. Was 0 for 3 as the DH last night. Grisham for the year hitting 250. 9 hits and 36 at bats, 1 homer, and 7 driven in. First pitch is a ball. Grisham, Odom, and Harp due up in the Bearcat eighth inning. Keckley is throwing 41 pitches out of the bullpen. Grisham now in a hitter's count. He's been outstanding. 2 2/3 of scoreless relief work. One hit allowed, no walks. Now 3-0. Keckley has also struck out 4. Three and one on Grisham. The 4 strikeouts equals a season high for Keckley. And there's a 5-pitch walk. Just what the Bearcats needed. First leadoff man to reach for the Bearcats since the 5th inning. Here's Odom's first at bat today. Might try to bunt his way on. And Heefner comes out of the dugout. A right-hander up and working in the DBU bullpen. Heefner might be out to talk some strategy defensively. Odom, 5 hits and 16 at bats this year. Hitting 313. Productive bat off the bench for the Bearcats. Looks like Heefner stalling a bit as the right-hander continues to get loose down in the Patriot bullpen. Sean Boyle is the righty getting loose down there. Well, I agree with the umpire. This is about as long as a visit as you could ever have. And the signal's finally made after Brian Clark had a few words for Heefner. Now Heefner taking as long as possible before making the call. Sean Boyle into this game. Bearcats with the tying run on. We'll be back to Huntsville after this.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools. For nearly 500,000 student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar, so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
What does it mean to be Southland Strong?
It's not just big wins.
It's success in the classroom.
And being engaged with service.
Family.
Passion.
Integrity.
Overcoming adversity.
Hard work and dedication.
Bettering people around you.
Striving for excellence.
Leadership and competition.
On our campuses.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Sean Boyle, the right-hander, comes into this game. He's been outstanding this season. The senior out of Selden, New York. Tenth appearance, all out of the pen, a 1.42 ERA. 10 hits allowed in 12 2/3 innings. 3 walks and 21 strikeouts. Ridiculous numbers. Almost 2 strikeouts per inning for Boyle. Well, speaking before the game today with Coach Dan Heefner of Dallas Baptist, he said, we're still trying to find our bullpen roles. Boyle seems to have the numbers to be the closer. But no saves yet on the year. Parker Towns leads DBU with two saves. A big spot here for Matt Odom. Bearcats trying to even this three-game series. See if Odom tries to bunt here, if they put Grisham in motion. Odom squares and takes ball one. Boyle's last time out was against Baylor. On Tuesday, gave up one run on two hits in four innings, struck out seven. Live arm out of the pen. Odom squares, pushes a bunt towards first, and it's caught. Odom, normally a very good bunter, that time did not execute. Now Clayton Hart bats for the first time today. 0 for 1 last night. Lefty against the righty Boyle. Strike one. Hart hitting 328 on the year. This is Hart's second at bat, I beg your pardon. He grounded out to second base his first time up. Grisham leads from first, and it's smoked out to right. Hit high and deep and carried, and it's out of here. A two-run shot for Clayton Harp, and the Bearcats are back in front, 6-5. What a swing from Harp. And I would bet the happiest man in that dugout is Mac Odom. After he popped up the bunt, Harp picks up his teammates and he'll get bullied on his way back to the dugout. What a swing. Got those arms extended and just smoked it out to right. Beautiful from Harp, his second homer of the year. Now it's Hafner. Curveball drops in there for a strike. RBI is 8-9 on the season. Bearcats like scoring late. They had 3 in the 7th, 2 in the 9th last night. And they get 2 here in the 8th to take a 6-5 lead. That's the second homer allowed this season by Boyle. He gave up a homer against Baylor in his 4 strong innings on Tuesday. Fouls behind first. This sets up an interesting 9th inning. Dakota Mills, I would guess, will come in for the 9th. Bearcats with a 6-5 lead, still only 1 out in the 8th. Fastball is outside. What a swing for Harp. Bearcats have swept their first 2 Southland Conference opponents. They did not want to stare down the barrel of a possible home sweep if they did not win today. It's lined back up the middle, a base hit from Hafner. Boyle left it up in the zone and Hafner takes advantage. A rough day in the field, but he has 3 hits at the plate. Now it's Trey Ochoa. Ochoa struck out his last time. He's also walked and reached on an infield single. On base in 20 straight games. There he squares to bunt in. Fastball misses outside. What a moment for Harp. He has started most of the games this season. Did not start today, but he comes off the bench in the clutch. A two-run homer in the eighth to give the Bearcats a 6-5 lead. Runner goes, swing through it. It was a late read from the catcher, and his throw was not in time. It's interesting for Matt Deuce. It was almost like he didn't understand that the base runner was going. His throw was a little bit delayed. So we take another look. Hafner with the steal. And now Matt Deggs walks and chats with Trey Ochoa before this 1-1 pitch. Hafner's second steal in as many tries this season. Top of the order, Hunter Hearn on deck. Six-five Bearcats. And it's off the glove of the catcher, Deuce. Deuce, a very good defensive catcher, having some problems here in the eighth. A stolen base in which he seemed to get off a delayed throw, and that time a catchable pitch goes to the backstop off his glove. That changes things for the Bearcats. Now the infield will come in at the corners. And up the middle as well. 2-1 on Ochoa. Hafner leads from third. Boyle to the plate. It's a squeeze and it's foul back. Now the suicide squeeze deployed by the Bearcats. A 2-2, swing and a miss, so Ochoa cannot get the bunt down, and then strikes out. Here's Hunter Hearn. Hearn, a rare 0-for-4 today. A strikeout, two flyouts, and a ground out. An RBI opportunity with two outs in the eighth. Swings and misses. The 0-1. Over the outside. Bearcats with two in the first, one in the fourth and the fifth, and two in the eighth. Two big home runs today. Chisholm to the opposite field in the first, and then Clayton Harp. A line drive out to right. Six, five Bearcats, two outs in the eighth. This is hit out to left, carrying, but in the ballpark, and Bandy makes the catch. Hafner is left at third, but the big moment in the inning, and so far the big moment in this game, Clayton Harp is second homer of the season as we take another look. Now to the ninth inning from Huntsville. Bearcats lead the Patriots 6-5.
From there, in the A36, B30, C.
Now the ninth inning from Don Sanders Stadium. Matt Peterson with you. Some folks enjoying some good baseball. Back and forth contest for the second straight day between two very good programs, the Bearcats and the Patriots. Dakota Mills, the new closer, comes out of the bullpen. He has been sensational as of late. And his numbers for the season, 1-0 with a 1.96 earned run average. This is his ninth appearance of the year, two as a starter. And he'll try to lock down his fifth save of the year. And he'll have to do it against the top of the order for the Patriots. Hannah, Granberg, and Deuce due up. Mills, all four of his saves on each of his last four appearances. Two games in the Texas A&M Corpus Christi series last weekend, and then at Baylor before that, a two-inning save, and then at Lamar on the opening weekend, 2 2/3. Jameson Hannah will begin the ninth inning for DBU. Hannah's 2-for-4 today, batting .407 on the year. Dakota Mills comes to the plate. Fastball is low. How about these numbers for Mills? Over his last five appearances, 13 innings, four saves, 24 strikeouts, and one walk. That's popped up, foul, back and out of play. You heard that right, 24 strikeouts and one walk in his last five appearances. 1-1 the count. This is roped down the right field line, slicing towards the corner, foul near the bullpen. Mills, a redshirt senior, had 11 strikeouts against Prairie View in his last start and has carried that strikeout form out of the bullpen. Just low, 2-2. Nearly two strikeouts per inning on the year for Dakota Mills. So far, 32 Ks in 18 1/3 frames. A 2-2. Strike three, a fastball over the inside. Hannah down on strikes. One out for Mills in the ninth. Devlin Granberg, a very dangerous hitter, will stand in as the possible tying run. He smoked a three-run homer out to left field in the sixth inning that gave DBU a 5-4 lead. Bearcats have come back to take a 6-5 advantage as that spins high. One ball, no strikes. I asked Coach Deggs before the game about Mills, his emergence as the closer. He says he did it out of necessity. They needed a closer as that pitch misses low. Nick Mikulacik started the season as the closer but had a few wobbles early in the year and has been used more as a starter and a long reliever out of the bullpen. Now Mills has really taken the closer role to heart. That pitch is low. 3-0 the count. See if Granberg has the green light. And he takes a high strike. Granberg, a single, a double, and a three-run homer. Big pitch here on 3-1. Right there, a fastball, and now the count is full. Granberg steps out. Here's the pitch. Foul back. He was right on top of that. Amberg hitting over 500 in his last 10 games. Here is the 3-2. Fouled off, a good battle between the slugging first baseman, Devlin Granberg, and the Bearcat closer, Dakota Mills, looking for his fifth consecutive save in his many appearances. And he walked him. A fastball from Mills that missed the strike zone, and Granberg skips down to first base. Good battle between those two. And now Matt Deuce steps to the plate. Granberg's the possible tying run at first. Deuce today is 0 for 3. Reached on an error, a sacrifice fly, and two flyouts. First pitch is low. One ball, no strikes. Popped up, back and out of play. Matt Deuce is a senior who was drafted in the 14th round by the Mets in last year's draft. Honorable mention, All-Missouri Valley pick last year. Second team All-Missouri Valley 2 years ago. 1-1. Granberg runs, and it's a high fly ball down the right field line, slicing towards the bullpen, and it's foul. McKnight, who has come in the game to play right field, was hoping for a play, but it was about 3 feet beyond the wall. McKnight's in right, Odom's in center, Clayton Harp is in left. The infield for the Bearcats, Grisham, Ochoa, Frigé, Hafner, first to third. Jordan Cannon, the catcher. 1-2 the count. The pitch from Mills. And it's blooped out to shallow center. Tough play. Frigé hoping to make a catch. He dives and it bounces into center. Oh, too far for Odom. And too far for Frigé. Right on top of the Bearcat logo. A tough hit to allow on 1-2. Not a bad pitch at all from Dakota Mills. Deuce just fought it off. A walk and a bloop single. And now it's Tim Millard. Matt Deggs will walk out and talk with Dakota Mills in his infield. As good as Mills has been, you expected DBU to not go quietly. A very, very good offensive team. That walk, by the way, two batters ago to Granberg, the first walk issued by Mills since his start against Prairie View. And only his second walk of the season. That's how good Mills has been. At 32-1 strikeout to walk ratio before play today. That's how rare of an occurrence a free pass has been for Mills. Matt Deggs back towards the dugout. Millard will step to the batter's box. He's 0 for 3 today. Struck out looking. Has popped up, been hit by a pitch, and hit a fly ball to right. Granberg's at second, Deuce is at first. Evan Sandman on deck. A double play would end the game. Good fastball right there for a strike. Millard, second team All-Missouri Valley Conference last year. Led the Patriots second in the league with 62 runs batted in and 43 walks a year ago. 0-1 the count. And it's fouled back. Malone is right on that. Now Mills in a pitcher's count at 0-2. Mills gets his sign from Jordan Cannon. Swing and a miss, a high fastball. Millard cannot lay off. Now Mills and the Cats are one out away from evening this three-game series. Second strikeout of the inning for Mills. Evan Sandman stands in from the left side. 0 for 3 today, reached on an error, a fly out, a walk, and a pop out. The high set for Mills. Fastball foul back. The inning began with Mills striking out Jameson Hanna. Caught him looking. Then after a lengthy battle, Devlin Granberg worked a walk. Deuce blooped a single to shallow center, and then Millar just struck out. 0-1. Maybe a bit high, maybe wide. Some howls from the Bearcats dugout. Cody Funderburk, the starting pitcher for DBU, would be next. The pitch. Just missed. 2-1. Bearcats trying for a comeback victory. They trailed 5-4 going to the bottom of the eighth, but Clayton Harp, a two-run shot off of Boyle, one of the best relievers on the Patriots. The pitch, foul back. Challenge fastball, and Sandman has had two healthy swings. The Patriots, they're a slugging team. Amongst the national leaders in homers a year ago, amongst the national leaders in doubles this year in many offensive categories. Power against power here with Sandman standing in against Dakota Mills. The Bearcats are one strike away. Here's Mills, foul back. Another fastball up in the zone. Sandman able to stay alive. Crowd urging Mills on. Here's the 2-2. Protective cut from Sandman that time. He fouled it off. Mills trying for his fifth straight save. Has the sign. 2-2. Here it comes. Popped up behind third. Haefner hoping for a play, and he makes the catch, and the ball game is over. Dakota Mills shuts the door once again. Two games and two hard-fought ball games between these two rivals. And the Bearcats even the series with a come-from-behind 6-5 victory. And Clayton Harp, one of the heroes, a two-run shot. The game-winning homer in the eighth inning. Mills, his fifth save in as many tries, all coming in his last five appearances. And the Bearcats will look for the series win tomorrow afternoon. It's a 1 p.m. first pitch as the Bearcats host Dallas Baptist in the finale. What a game this was. Three impressive home runs. Blake Chisholm, a two-run shot in the first. Harp, a two-run shot, a game-winning homer in the eighth. Devlin Granberg, a three-run homer in the sixth. Granberg and Chisholm both were a triple shy of the cycle. The win goes to Nick Mikulacik, he's 3-3. Sean Boyle takes the loss, he's 0-1. Dakota Mills, his fifth save. I'm Matt Peterson saying so long from Don Sanders Stadium. The final score, The Bearcats come from behind. They beat Dallas Baptist by the score of 6-5. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on our family of ESPN networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.